Be in no doubt, this was a significant setback for Prince Andrew today. His accuser, Virginia Giuffre, here in this now widely seen photo from 2001, called it her pursuit of justice. The prince's legal team, perhaps not surprisingly, has yet to respond.
Or anyone else that has
the lawsuit brought by Ms. Giuffre, seen here in 2019, will continue on its legal path. It is a path that leads towards a trial. She is suing Prince Andrew, alleging she was trafficked to him for sex on three occasions in 2001. Prince Andrew's lawyer argued he was covered by this document. It is a settlement agreement from 2009 when Jeffrey Epstein paid Virginia Giuffre $500,000. In return, she agreed not to take legal action against any other potential defendants. Last week in a New York court, Andrew's team argued he was such a potential defendant. But today the judge ruled he was not. The 2009 agreement, he wrote, cannot be said to demonstrate clearly and unambiguously that the parties intended the instrument directly, primarily or substantially to benefit Prince Andrew. So he decided the defendant, Prince Andrew's, motion to dismiss the complaint is denied in all respects.
After this ruling, there is no logical stopping point between here and trial.
So what is the process now that this motion to dismiss has been denied?
What's called discovery in America. That is the process by which documents and testimony are exchanged between the parties. Prince Andrew will be required to sit for a court-ordered interview on video where he will be questioned for up to 7 hours of running time.
Prince Andrew has always denied the allegations. He's also said he does not recall ever meeting Virginia Giuffre. And while his side remained silent today, his accuser responded via her lawyers. They said, today's decision by Judge Kaplan denying Prince Andrew's efforts to dismiss Virginia Giuffre's case against him is another important step in Virginia's heroic and determined pursuit of justice as a survivor of sex trafficking. Buckingham Palace said today it would not comment on what it called an ongoing legal matter. But in the year the Queen celebrates 70 years of reign, right now her son is heading towards a trial. Chris Hipp News at 10.